Monologue 75, The Ministry of Infrastructure, Kingdom 10. There are to be 7 agencies within the Ministry of Infrastructure or Infrastructural Management. 1. Roads and Bridges. 2. Energy, Power Generation and Grid. 3. Telecommunications, the Network and Systems. 4. Waste Management, Garbage, Sewers, Water Treatment. 5. Transportation and Mass Transit, Planes, Trains, etc. 6. Urban Planning, Development and Housing. 7. National Buildings and Maintenance. This ministry is to be focused on the nuts and bolts operation of the nation, overseeing every mundane aspect of keeping the whole thing running in a cohesive and well-coordinated fashion. More than merely fixing things, the ministry will seek to reform and reorganize the national infrastructure to improve upon, upgrade, fine-tune, and increase the efficiency of the entire system. The Agency of Energy will focus on keeping existing energy grids working, while also developing energy systems that are cleaner and more efficient, such as solar, wind, geothermal, neutron reactors, etc. Dependence on foreign sources of energy must be reduced as much as possible. The Agency of Transportation and Mass Transit is to focus on shifting the entire nation from dirty fuel forms of transport to more efficient and cleaner types of vehicles. The Brazilian model, for those who have knowledge, is one approach. Over time, however, clean mass transit systems should be created and expanded to decrease the number of personal vehicles on the roads. This agency should also oversee the nation's airports, railways, bus lines, etc. The Agency of Urban Planning, Development, and Housing is fairly self-explanatory, and yet over the long run, this agency must focus on transforming the entire face of the nation, so that it is more organized and laid out in a more efficient pattern. Yet their greatest and highest goal is to slowly move development downward. Working in harmony with the Ministry of Defense, the AUPDH is to literally begin to construct cities beneath the surface of the earth, which are to be extremely designed with an eye to redundancy, strength, and efficiency. Such subterranean cities are to be well lit and well ventilated and highly stable. In line with the concept of biodomes, such underground urbanization would use green technologies, combining natural order with architectural designs, and enable high levels of self-containment and self-sufficiency. Moreover, even mass transit itself should become increasingly subterranean in nature. Those with knowledge will know that there are ways to channel natural light directly into underground areas, and that there are many benefits of developing a subterranean civilization. By building downward and then outward, surface space is saved and can be restored to a natural state, replacing urban and suburban sprawl with beautiful parks and agrarian zones. Using natural rock and earth itself, less building materials, trees, are used. The environment is more controllable and less subject to surface weather conditions, and the entire civilization becomes much more defensible and concealable. Yet I strongly encourage you to build your underground cities and towns with beauty and livability in mind, with mosaics, natural lighting, archways, riverways, towering forms, and a grandiose vision of melding nature with infrastructure. Moreover, the cities must also be created as immense bomb shelters and fortresses, well-ordered, strategic, and martial, militant, combining the militaristic with the artistic, the technological with the archaic, the aesthetic with the functional. Always, citizens should have easy and multiple accesses to the surface so that they may enjoy the vast contemplative parks that will be replacing their surface cities, and so that they may work in the agrarian zones that provide food for the subterranean nation. With an eye to survival, it is also important that underground farms and/or gardening techniques be developed as well. All other agencies within the ministry should coordinate their future efforts around the overall development goals. The Agency of National Building and Maintenance is to be responsible for all public and government buildings, their upkeep, construction, and improvement.